हेलो एवरीवन, आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल। आई अमनदीप कौर। वी वर ऑन चैप्टर 7 जियोमेट्री एंड दिस इज़ द थर्ड वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ चैप्टर जियोमेट्री। इन द लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एंगल्स एंड इट्स टाइप्स वर डिस्कस्ड। नाउ लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द सेम टॉपिक एंगल। डियर चिल्ड्रन, वी ऑल आर सराउंडेड बाय एंगल्स। यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन देर इज लैपटॉप। देर आर फोर कॉर्नर्स and on each corner of the laptop on the screen there is formation of 90 degree angle. Even you can see in the slice of pizza there is formation of acute angle. Now see clock. On the clock there is formation of obtuse angle when the time is 5 o'clock, and on the left side of the clock angle is more than 180 degree. Angle is more than 180 degree, so which is an example of reflex angle. So with these pictures you can understand the concept of angle better. So now angle can be measured using a protractor. You can see here a protractor, and on a protractor there are two scales, inner scale and outer scale. Numbers starts from 0 to 180 degree and move clockwise on the outer scale, and inner scale numbers also starting from 0 to moving 180 degree but moving along anti-clockwise. So here is a bottom line, this is the bottom line, and this is the center. This is the center point of protractor, and we used symbol degree to measure an angle like 10 degree, 30 degree, so on. This symbol is used, degree symbol is used to measure an angle. Now see how to measure an angle. This is center point of the protractor. You need to keep on the center line, or you need to keep it on the corner of an angle. This is a corner, or we can call it as vertex of an angle. Touch the center point on that point, and baseline you need to keep it on the one of the line of an angle. So see, so now there is formation of 60 degree angle. This point, this line lies on 60 degree. 0, 10, 20, 30 moves on till 60. So that angle is 60 degree angle. You can write here 60 degree angle. Angle A, B, C is the 60 degree angle. Now see one more question. So here angle P, Q, R you need to measure. Again keep the center line, center point on the corner of the angle. And you can see the inner scale, you can note down 0, 10, 20 moving forward, and it reached till 90. So that line is on 90. So it's formation of right angle, that is 90 degree angle. So angle PQR, you can write here 90 degree angle. And that is right angle. And now see angle LMN. Again you need to keep the center line, center point on the corner of an angle, and line, bottom line should touch the line. Now you can see, again you need to see inner scale starting from 0, moving 10, 20, so on, and it reached till 120. You need to read the inner scale here. You will read here inner scale. So 120 degree angle. So we can write it as angle LMN is equals to 120 degree. So here also we can mention. Now see one more example. So here is straight line. So we need to keep line, need to keep center point on the center line, and baseline, bottom line should touch the line. And it starts from 0. You can see 10, 20, 30, so on, 100, 120, 160, 170, 180. So it reached till 180. So it is straight line. So it is a 180 degree angle. We can mention here 180 degree. So angle ABC is 180 degree angle, straight angle. Same. So here, if there is circle around a circle, we know there is formation of complete angle. So that is 360 degree angle. So now, next concept is types of line and type polygon. Under types of line, you will see coplanar, parallel, intersecting and perpendicular lines, and polygon, triangle and quadrilateral. Now see first types of lines. First is coplanar lines. Two lines lying in the same plane are called coplanar lines. You can see here AB and CD are two lines, both lines lying in the same plane. So these two lines are coplanar lines. Next concept is parallel lines. Two or more coplanar lines that do not intersect are called parallel lines. Two lines which do not intersect each other, do not cut each other, these are the parallel lines. And symbol we use for parallel lines, two vertical lines. Some examples of parallel lines, you can see tracks of rail line. So railway tracks is an example of parallel lines. Even banks of canal is an example of parallel lines. Then the types of parallel lines are vertical parallel lines, vertical form drawn, horizontal parallel lines, and the third is slanting parallel lines, or you can say oblique parallel lines. Next concept is intersecting lines. Two or more lines that cross each other are called intersecting line. You can see here line AB and CD, both lines intersect or cut each other at point X, meet each other at point X. So these two lines AB and CD are intersecting line. So see the example of intersecting lines. Even you can see on the floor and even on the wall, intersecting lines tap to the walls. That just mean they just touch each other. Now the next is perpendicular line. The line that intersect or meet each other to form a right angle are called perpendicular line. You can see here AB, line AB and CD cut each other or intersect each other by formation of 90 degree angle. So these two lines are perpendicular lines. In the second figure you can see, so ZO line intersecting XY by making 90 degree angle. So OZ is perpendicular to XY. Symbol, this symbol is used for denoting perpendicular lines. So here you can see in the second figure OZ is perpendicular to XY. In the third figure, here we can see AB is perpendicular to BC, and on the right hand side, DC is perpendicular to BC. So next you can see example. So there is formation of 90 degree angle. Two lines intersect each other by formation of right angle. So that is the example of perpendicular surface. So now window pane, four squares, floor tiles, these all are examples of perpendicular lines that meet each other at a 90 degree angle, means with the formation of right angle. So let's take a recap. See the difference between parallel, perpendicular and intersecting line. Parallel line never touch each other. Perpendicular line cross each other with the formation of right angle. Intersecting line cross each other but do not make a right angle. Now the polygons. A closed figure made up of three or more than three line segments that do not cross each other is called a polygon. See the example. See polygon, types of polygon. A triangle is a polygon with three sides. A quadrilateral is a polygon made up of four line segments. You can see here, triangle is a closed figure, is a type of polygon. And square and rectangles are the polygons having more than three sides, so polygon termed as quadrilateral. Next figure is five side figure, closed figure with five side, pentagon. It is also a polygon. Next you can see here the hexagon with sky blue color, six sides. A closed figure with made by six line segments. So it's a polygon with six sides. Heptagon with seven sides. Octagon, a closed figure with eight sides. It is also termed as polygon. Nonagon with nine sides. Decagon is a polygon with 10 sides. Thanks. Have a great day.